This has got to be an A-list track. But don't forget, we do want Andy C to be able to play it at Fabric, and it needs to be able to work on a festival stage.
And all those things are true, but at the same time, you go fucking do it then.
Hi, I'm Gareth.
And I'm Rob. We're from Pendulum, and this is the story of Propane Nightmares. Generally, songs are just called whatever the name happens to be when I start a new project. And this is before we've even written anything. And by the end of the song, we're attached to it. We were listening to a lot of bands, a lot of sort of Devin Townsend and Strapping Young Lad and Muse and all that stuff. For some reason, write something that sounded kind of like a Nintendo version of that, the sort of chords those guys put together. Ended up going through a few iterations and becoming some rock thing and then turned into a mariachi band. And it was,
yeah.
I'm not sure if these were versions, but there was about 600 files.
We knew the musical elements were right, but in what form that they came was the search.
Warners were like, okay, well, we've got this budget allocation for recording, and we're like, but we do all the recording at home. But they were giving us the time, so we thought we'd use it.
And so we're like, we'll have that studio.
Yeah. If you hear acoustic drums on that album, it's from
Olympic,
from those sessions. Everything apart from the drums was recorded in the flat. The bass, the guitars, the vocals.
In the master bedroom where we set up the studio, there was a wall of what looked like wardrobes, but we opened them and they were only about 6 inches deep and were set up in small squares. It was a perfect soundtrack.
I think we had quite an expensive mic set up in the cheapest room in the world. Facing a corner was like just foam that we'd glued to the walls and further ruined our deposit.
The mic was worth more than the house, I think.
It was definitely more than our yearly rent.
Yeah, yeah.
For a while, we're like, well, I can't believe the neighbors haven't been playing. We got speakers and subs and everything set up. And then, like, one day I remember sitting in the lounge and hearing, like, a kettle boiling and, like, shh, and we're like, oh shit. Out of every Pendulum track, I don't know how many there are. If it's been finished, then it's come off my computer. I've sort of rendered it, sent it off for mastering. That's the only one where it wasn't me.
As we said, it wasn't finished, it escaped. It was one of those ones that we kind of had a lot of pressure put on us to have it be the next single. And yeah, it escaped.
About the Heaven's Gate cult. They were convinced there was some salvation in an asteroid which happened to be passing Earth.
And if they took their lives at a certain moment, they would be transported onto the
next realm or something.
Via this comet.
It was one of the few music videos we've had where the director was completely nailed the theme.
And I think the narrative there was the people that refused to take the suicide liquid were the ones that escaped at the end, I guess, to tell the story.
I think it pushed us onto a new track and then we kept going with it. With Propane Nightmares and In Silico, it turned off a lot of drum and bass people, but a whole lot of new people that didn't even give a shit about drum and bass came on board, which to us was like, perfect, that's what we want to do.